talk to me differently insofar as they start telling me about their experience, or their sister's experience, or their friend's experience. Things are different because now I know that depression is the family secret that everyone has. I went a few years ago to a conference, and on Friday of the three-day conference, one of the participants took me aside and she said, I suffer from depression and I'm a little embarrassed about it, but I've been taking this medication and I just wanted to ask you what you think. And so I did my best to give her such advice as I could, and then she said, you know, my husband would never understand this. He's really the kind of guy, Jill, this wouldn't make any sense. So I just, you know, it's just between us. And I said, yeah, that's fine. On Sunday, at the same conference, her husband took me aside. And he said, my wife wouldn't think that I was really much of a guy if she knew this, but I've been dealing with this depression and I'm taking some medication and I wondered what you think. They were hiding the same medication in two different places in the same bedroom. And I said that I thought communication within the marriage might be triggering some of their problems. But I was also struck by the burdensome nature of such mutual secrecy. Depression is so exhausting. It takes up so much of your time and energy, and silence about it, it really does make the depression worse. Schizophrenics who perceive that there's something foreign inside of them that needs to be exercised, but it's difficult with depressives because we believe we are seeing the truth. People say to me, well, is it continuous with normal sadness? And I say, in a way, it's continuous with normal sadness. There is a certain amount of continuity, but it's the same way that continuity between having an iron fence outside your house and a little rust spot, which you have to sort of sand off and maybe do a little repainting, and what happens if you leave the house. Thank you.
This is what the road looks like to the top of a steering wheel. If it had eyes. Because obviously it doesn't. Or at least not that we know of. So that's been a little driving video from, I think it was called the 138 in Oregon, over to the 5, which is what we're on now, Got off at one point because I toyed with the idea of going to Crater Lake, but it was 62 miles and it was already starting to kind of get dark, so I decided against that. So that's why we got off back there. And then ever since then, I was just kind of trying to move the camera a little bit like you would if you were riding in a car, kind of how you look out the side, out the front, and then of course there was a top of the steering wheel view, which is what we're doing right now, and we're going to stop in just a sec because it's very distracting to have a big camera. The camera's on this big freaking mount, so I kind of get depth perception problems as I kind of stare through it and try to drive, which was fun for a little bit, but it starts to get a little weird when start coming up on traffic, so kind of bobbing my head back and forth. Oh no, don't you do that. And I just remembered that I left my chain for my Hightower in Scott and Christie's garage. I took it off and planned on cleaning it, and decided it was late and I was going to bed, and that's when I did my stretch that popped my ribcage. So, which was already stressed from a crash out in Cape Mountain from a few days earlier, and that stretch seemed to actually have either caused the fracture or moved my ribcage in such a way that something tore, not sure. But it's been much less fun ever since that happened. Not overall, but still had lots of good quality time with my friends. But it would have been nice to not have to spend the day going to the urgent care in Eugene. Although Eugene was beautiful and I probably wouldn't have gotten over there otherwise. So hey, you know, things happen, and sometimes even though they're not exactly what you want to be doing, you end up going somewhere and seeing some things that you wouldn't have seen otherwise. So, alright, I'm going to sign off. So I hope you've enjoyed this presentation of Nonsense TV.